So, I will adjourn the case until this coming Monday at 11 a.m. I will remand the defendant without bail at this time. And
Judge,
I would hope that you would reconsider
no
the questions of whether or not you're going to be represented by counsel.
I'm not going to be represented by counsel. This case is, I'm being illegally remanded to jail again. The court sentenced me to shock probation. The maximum shock term is 60 days. You indicated that on the record, so you're aware of it. You took me into custody again, making that shock sentence illegal. You're relying on 1193 and you're incorrect.
I'll read your papers.
Judge, I can't submit my papers from jail.
So I suggest that you have counsel to assist you.
I can't obtain counsel in jail. There's no legal authority for the court to incarcerate me. I came here today willingly of my own volition with 1 hour's notice that I had a court appearance.
You are remanded without bail until Monday at 11 a.m.
You cannot incarcerate me just because you're able to.
We are concluded with this proceeding.
This is illegal. You're illegally incarcerating me again. This is the third time you've illegally incarcerated me. There's no actual violation of my conditional discharge. You are not able to just make the law.
Estacio, Mr. Salmon is here representing Ms. Estacio. Mr. Maurer is here for the people. I have before me a second amended information for delinquency alleging that the defendant has violated conditions of probation in several respects. Number one, failing to cooperate with continuous alcohol monitoring program and following all rules and procedures, and that on or about July 13, 2017, she did not plug in her SCRAM base unit. Paragraph 2 alleges that she failed to abstain from alcoholic beverages, and that on or about July 14, 2017 to July 15, 2017, she consumed alcohol and registered a peak 0.127% BAC on her SCRAM device.
Excuse me, I would waive a full reading of the entire information in the general denial on behalf of my client.
Very well. So, we'll enter a general denial. And I know that we did have a conference in chambers. There was some discussion about the possibility of a settlement or resolution. Let's hear counsel.
Judge, we did have an opportunity to speak in chambers. I did have an opportunity to review some information that had been provided to me by counsel. And then we again had a brief opportunity to speak before court today. Based on that sort of some admission, which I understand is not likely in this case, I don't think there is going to be a disposition. It appears that we may be in a position somebody's scheduled out for hearing.
Very well. Get your calendars out, gentlemen. How about Friday, November the 3rd at 1 p.m.?
Your Honor, prior to setting this hearing, I had filed, I believe, on October 10th before this court, a memorandum in support of termination of probation on behalf of my client, and I would ask that the court make a ruling with respect to that motion.
I didn't think it was a motion, Mr. Salmon. I thought it was a memorandum submitted in connection with the pretrial conference.
No, Your Honor, this was a memorandum in support of my motion for termination of probation on behalf of my.
So I would deny the motion, if it is a motion, at this time, without prejudice for you to renew that motion at some later point in time. How about November 3rd at 1 p.m.? Is that okay with everyone?
That works for us.
Yes, sir, Mr. President, the 3rd.
No. Very well. So at this time, I would order the defendant held without bail until the hearing date. And we'll see you all on November the 3rd.
Your Honor, may I defer with respect to my client's being held?
Briefly, Mr. Salmon.
Your Honor, at this time, these are just merely allegations from my client. I just been handed today documentation with respect to certain allegations with respect to my client from the people. I've not had an opportunity to speak to my client with respect to these allegations. These allegations have been outstanding for months now. We've had a request for discovery, and I'm just not receiving that today. Your Honor, I would ask that the court allow my client to remain out of custody so that I can speak with my client and adequately prepare defense for the hearing scheduled for next week.
Your application is denied, Mr. Salmon. Anything else for the record?
Nothing, Your Honor. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.
All right.
Thank you.